descend in a iota. After horizontal arc, descend in a iota goes below, and heat is called thoracic descent and perforates diaphragm, comes into the abdominal cavity and is called abdominal descent in a iota. You can see what are posterior branches, what are parietal branches. Do you see aorta? It gives, do you see? Do you see intercostal posterior arteries? Do you see it go into the intercostal spaces? What is number of the intercostal posterior arteries? Aorta goes along of the vertebral column and gives to both sides into the intercostal spaces, intercostal posterior arteries. What are number of them?
Six.
Ten. Ten, yes. But if you remember, from back, we supplied it to upper intercostal muscles. Do you see? Intercostal internal and intercostal external, two upper spaces. Do you remember? From what we supplied them? Costa cervical trunk from subclavian artery gave intercostal posterior suprem, which divided into the prima and secunda. How many ribs we have on each side?
12.
How many spaces between them?
Six.
No, we have 12 ribs. How many spaces between them?
Six.
12 ribs, and between them, six spaces. 11. Two we supplied, and 11 minus two will be how?
Nine.
And thoracic aorta gives how many branches?
Ten.
Because the last lower branch, it is placed below than the 12th rib, and it changes its name. It will be subcostal artery. Do you see? And will be correctly, the thoracic aorta gives the 10 intercostal posterior arteries, and lower from them will have name subcostal. Aorta perforates diaphragm. Do you see? Perforates diaphragm. And when it perforates diaphragm, it gives right and left phrenic superior arteries. If these arteries start from aorta, the blood very fast with very big pressure enters, do you see, by phrenic superior arteries into the diaphragm. By last lessons, we supplied diaphragm. What branches we gave from another artery, which will supply diaphragm and which will anastomosis with subdivisions of the phrenic superior artery. Pericardiacophrenic and musculophrenic. Pericardiacophrenic and musculophrenic arteries from thoracic internal artery, which is branch of the subclavian artery. Yes? Listen to me. How many objects we gave? Phrenic superior, pericardiacophrenic, musculophrenic. Inform me, please, what muscular regions diaphragm includes? Do you remember I showed you diaphragm? How many regions diaphragm includes? Lumbar, costal, and sternal. If you remember, diaphragm begins from lower four or five ribs, yes? And when the diaphragm, do you see, begins from ribs, from lower intercostal posterior, you can see this, do you see, intercostal spaces, and here begins diaphragm, do you see?
Mm-hmm.
Do you see? And because from lower four, five, and sometimes six intercostal spaces, the phrenic posterior arteries will give the intercostal posterior arteries will give phrenic branches. Now you can see here will be intercostal posterior and here begins diaphragm because by our order about short distance the intercostal posterior arteries into the diaphragm which begins from ribs will give phrenic branches. Phrenic superior is general from thoracic aorta. Pericardiacophrenic and musculophrenic from thoracic internal from subclavian system. And intercostal posterior arteries will give phrenic branches from intercostal posterior from thoracic aorta. Do you see? Next time we will start in one lesson, in after control, in two lessons later, we will study abdominal aorta. You can see thoracic aorta, do you see, goes below and gives, do you see, phrenic superior artery. Abdominal aorta continues below, it gives opposite phrenic inferior artery. Phrenic superior and phrenic inferior arteries, if they start from aorta, they will bring biggest portion of the blood by short distance and by bigger diameter, do you see? And these arteries will be general for the blood supply of the diaphragm. All another, pericardiaca, phrenic, muscular, phrenic from right and left, thoracic, internal, the phrenic branches from intercostal posterior, they will be helping, do you see? Because in the diaphragm, they will anastomosis. And please repeat me the parietal branches of the thoracic aorta.
Phrenic
superior, because diaphragm, this is lower wall. Parietes, this is wall. And? My dear, and intercostal posterior walls are formed by ribs and spaces between ribs, which do you see, include muscles. Do you see? And do you see if will be ribs and muscles between them, they will do walls. Do you see? You can see walls are ribs with, do you see, muscles which are placed between the ribs and diaphragm, and we gave for them vessels. Do you see? Listen to me. Another. You can see. Here is aorta. Do you see? From aorta, the arteries will come into the lungs for their blood supply. What are names of the arteries which go for the blood supply of the lungs?
Pulmonary arteries.
Mm-hmm.
Right and left.
My dear, pulmonary arteries, they are divisions of the pulmonary trunk which exits from right ventricle and brings to the lungs the deoxygenated blood for changing of it, for evacuation of it. And deoxygenated blood cannot supply the lungs. Because this is toxin, do you see? What are names of the arteries? Bronchial arteries, arteria bronchialis. They start from aorta and they bring the blood, subdivide many times in the lungs, and they bring oxygen. Okay, another, look here, this is aorta, and this tube, do you see, which joins from right side to aorta, esophagus. And esophagus is long. Do you remember? It has cervical region, thoracic region, and smaller abdominal region. Yes? Listen to me. In the thoracic region, along of this very longest region, aorta gives 3 or 4 esophageal branches. Yes? Recollect me. Here, do you see, aorta gives the esophageal arteries by short distance. Esophagus lies near and it gives, do you see, to side the esophageal arteries. Cervical region of the esophagus. From what artery it can be supplied? Thyra, cervical trunk, it gives, to the back, it gives thyroid inferior artery, before visit to the thyroid gland, gives esophageal cervical branches to the cervical region of the esophagus. To the abdominal region, we will give later the branches from subdivisions of the abdominal aorta. Cervical region supplies by esophageal branches from thyroid inferior, which is branch of the thyrocervical trunk from subclavian artery. And listen to me, around of the esophagus, this artery will do common net. Cervical region will get from subclavian system. Now I informed you. Thoracic region, it's the very biggest, and it takes the general big portion of the blood. If, for example, we will ligate thyroid inferior arteries, if we will do operation about thyroid gland, esophagus will get blood from lower by this common plexus, do you see, which covers compactly the whole esophagus. Do you see? Okay. Another. Look this here. This is, do you see, aorta. This is aorta. And this is, do you see, pericardium, pocket for the heart. The pericardium is very important for the heart because pericardium, this is serous membrane. From inside it's covered by serous cells, do you see, which produce the fluid, secretion cells. And do you see, the heart every time works in the pericardiac space between epicardium and pericardium, every time must be fluid. Do you understand? Because if the pericardium is very important for the heart, it gets the biggest portion of the blood by pericardiac artery from aorta, thoracic aorta, and where it will take all the blood?
That's right.
Here, remember, here not remember. 3 minutes ago, 5 minutes ago, we said pericardiaca phrenic artery. My dear, trainer, your logic, if the artery includes in the name the word pericardiac, pericardiaca phrenic artery from right thoracic internal and from left thoracic internal will subdivide in the pericardium and will anastomosis with pericardiac arteries. Did you understand? Okay. And who will recollect me? What is mediastinum? Mediastinum is collection of the organs which are placed between mediastinal pleures. This is very correct characteristic. Incorrectly, we can say between lungs, many organs. You can see here, trachea, bronch, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, lymphatic nodes, phrenic nerve, the vagus nerve, thoracic lymphatic duct, esophagus, heart with pericardium. Do you see? You can see heart with supplied from ascending aorta. Esophagus was supplied from thoracic aorta. Pericardium was supplied from thoracic aorta and from pericardiaca phrenic arteries. Did you understand? All another objects, for example, wall of the vein, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, wall of the vein for its comfort life, for its comfort condition, must get the blood, because into the each object will enter from thoracic aorta mediastinal arteries. We will give the general name for them. If we'll go to the trachea, we'll call tracheal artery, do you see? If we'll go, do you see, for example, to the thoracic lymphatic duct, will be artery of the thoracic lymphatic duct. Did you understand? Artery of the phrenic nerve, it will go into the sheath of the nerve, do you see? Together, these arteries are called mediastinal arteries. Mediastinal arteries will supply all smaller objects, lymphatic nodes, lymphatic ducts, lymphatic vessels, veins, and trachea, do you see? And we have mediastinal branches, pericardiac arteries, esophageal arteries, bronchial arteries. This will be bronchial, esophageal, pericardiac, and mediastinal visceral branches of the thoracic aorta. Intercostal posterior number 10 and right and left phrenic superior. This will be to the walls parietal. Pericardiac, esophageal, bronchial, and mediastinal. This will be visceral. Did you understand? Okay, sit.
Organism of health, the nerve system which controls all functions of our organism. All objects, all functions of our organism. Nerve system, it divides into the somatic nerve system and vegetative nerve system. Somatic, soma, this is box of the our organism, thoracic cavity, abdominal cavity, do you see? This, do you see, these are upper and lower limbs. What we have? We have skin, we have muscles, we have bones, we have joints, do you see? These all objects, they are called soma, and somatic nerve system controls these all objects. Besides all these objects, it controls the sensory organs. And also in our organism, we have vegetative system. Vegetative system controls vital functions. They're all internal organs, and by another word, vegetative nerve system controls the secretion tissue and smooth muscular tissue. Somatic nerve system controls the skeletal muscles and sensory organs. No sensory organs, vision, hearing, taste, but do you remember, we have many sensory receptors, do you see, in the skin, in the muscles we have receptors, do you see, because, do you see, sensory organs can be, do you see, concrete, local, do you see, and individual, or, do you see, can be present into the whole tissue for the sensation. Did you understand? Somatic nerve system, it controls the sensory organs and skeletal muscles. Vegetative nerve system, we will study later, vital functions. Digestive, respiratory, reproductive, and all another functions. By another words, it controls the smooth muscular tissue, the whole small, smooth muscular tissue which is present in our organism, and secretion tissue. For today, we spoke with you about cranial nerves. Do you remember? Which do you see control more of objects of the head and neck? The nuclei or centers from which begin cranial nerves, they are placed in the brain. Mm-hmm. And concretely in the brain stem. Mm-hmm. Brain is placed in the head. The nerves which exit, do you see, from brain through the opens of the skull, through the short distance, control all things. Yes? Except vagus nerve, and except one exception, phrenic nerve, about which I will inform you today, later. And the phrenic nerve doesn't accord our order about short distance only after birth. Through the fetal life, through the embryonal life, this this phrenic nerve, do you see, it goes from its beginning to its object by short distance. Later I will explain you why. You know, on the first lesson for the study of the nerve system, we said spinal cord, do you see, is placed inside in the vertebral canal, yes? Spinal cord divides into the 31 portions which are called segmentus of the spinal cord. Segment of the spinal cord, this is portion of the nerve tissue which accords, do you see, one pair of the spinal nerves. From any portion of the spinal cord, do you see, one nerve will go to right, one to left, one to right, one to left. If you remember, I said you, vertebral column is formed by vertebras. The distances of the bodies of the vertebras are different. In the cervical region are very short, in the lumbar region they are long. Inside in the vertebral openings which complete into the vertebral canal is placed spinal cord. Spinal cord is formed by segmentus. Number of the vertebras in the vertebral canal 33-34. Number of the segmentus in the spinal cord is 31. The distances or lengths of one segmenta will be same in the different regions. Because in the upper region, you can see where the bodies of the vertebrae are short. The first nerve, spinal nerve, will exit on right and on left side and will go out by intervertebral opening. Second will go by second intervertebral opening. Third will go by third. But the distances of the vertebrae, the lengths of the vertebrae will increase and the segmentus will have the same distances. And the spinal cord by short segmentus will end near the second lumbar vertebra. Do you see? And vertebral canal will continue below. The nerves will hang and will hang by vertebral canal and will find their concrete door for the exit. About what I want to inform you. For example, first spinal nerve exits out from vertebral canal between first and second cervical vertebra. Fifth or third lumbar nerve, third lumbar nerve, it will exit from vertebral canal between third and fourth lumbar vertebra. And the spinal cord ends near the second. Did you understand? The nerve which exits, do you see, from lumbar third segment will go below and will exit between third and fourth. The, do you see, sacral segment which ends near the second lumbar vertebra, from it will exit nerve, will hang below and will exit by openings of the sacrum. Did you understand? You can see the following. This will be the first cervical segment of the spinal cord. First cervical segment of the spinal cord. If you remember, here are placed only posterior horns, they are sensory. And do you see, and here will be anterior horns. They are motor. Do you see? You can see, here will be spinal cord. This will be segment number one. Here will be segment number two. Here will be segment number three. Number four, number five, number six, number seven, and number eight. These are cervical segments. We have seven vertebras, but alone of them are placed eight cervical segments. Did you see? This will be, you can see, vertebral canal. Did you understand? You can see here into the vertebral canal from peripheral will come, do you see, the sensory information. Do you see? We have many thousands of the afferent neurons. Did you understand? Many thousands of the afferent neurons and their bodies will be in the spinal ganglion. Did you understand? Here, from motor neurons, do you see, will exit, do you see, many thousands of the motor fibers. They complete into the spinal nerve. Number one, on the right side and on the left side will be, do you see, number one, everywhere. Did you understand? Here, do you see, will exit number two. It is what? Mixed. Do you see? Sensory and motor. Here will be number two, number three, number four. This will be spinal nerve. Did you see? Each spinal nerve. In each region, in cervical, in thoracic, in lumbar, in sacral, how it exits from vertebral canal, it divides into two branches. One branch will collect sensory fibers and muscular fibers and will go to the back. To the back. Do you see? Another, do you see? Will complete sensory fibers and motor fibers and will go in front of. Did you see? You can see this will be posterior branch which divides into the cutaneous and into the muscular and here will be anterior branch. Another will go to the back and divides into the cutaneous and into the muscular. Another will go in front of the sensory and motor. Another will go to the back, do you see, and will divide into the cutaneous and muscular. Cutaneous and muscular. And anterior branches will include sensory portion and motor portion. Sensory portion and motor portion. Do you see? Listen to me. These nerves, do you see, what they will do? You can see. Anterior branches, my dear, anterior branches direct to the back. Posterior branches direct to the back. There, do you see, cutaneous branch will, do you see, control the skin. Muscular branch will control the muscles. For example, for your understanding. Look, please, here. I should table like this, posterior branch. No. The cutaneous branch will innervate skin. The muscular branch will innervate this level, for example, of this muscle. Another will innervate, like, do you see, line, the skin. Another, deeply behind of this line, the skin. This is called segmental according. If I will draw with you the back, do you see, it will be straighted. Because the sensory branch, which calls the posterior branches, these branches, do you see, every time they have segmental according, they will exit from the segment, and by this level will control muscles and superficially of these muscles, the skin. Will control another level of the muscles and superficially than them, the skin. These, do you see, are posterior branches of the spinal nerves. Do you see? Nerve exits and divides into two branches. One directly behind and divides into the sensory for the skin, it is called cutaneous, and another to the muscles which accord this portion of the skin. Anterior branches, look at what anterior branches do. Here and here, do you see, from first and second will complete, do you see, superior root, superior root. Superior root will be mixed. It includes sensory and motor portion. Sensory and motor portion. To another will produce inferior root, which will include sensory and motor portion. Listen to me. You can see, by last semester, we studied medulla oblongata. In the medulla oblongata, we studied hypoglossal nucleus, from which exits hypoglossal nerve, which comes into the tongue and controls the all muscles of the tongue. It passes through the hypoglossal canal. It will be broken on the base of the skull and will be cut hypoglossal nerve. The mobility of the tongue will decrease very much, but will not be lost. Why? Because from here and from here, the motor portion completes into the hypoglossal nerve, you can see, and will restore the smaller mobility of the tongue. And the patient cannot mix the food, cannot have the very correct speech, but the tongue will restore the smaller mobility. Look with here, another, you can see, from this is the inferior root. From superior root will collect the motor fibers, and from inferior will collect motor fibers. From superior and from inferior root we will collect the motor fibers. From superior root and from inferior root we will collect the motor fibers. From superior root and from inferior root we will collect the motor fibers. Do you see what we have? We have mixing and collection only of the motor fibers. And this motor fibers will go to the muscles of the neck.
except Myla Hyoid anterior belly of the digastric and genial hyoid, because when we studied cranial nerves, we gave for them the motor function from trigeminal nerve. Do you remember trigeminal nerve? It controls the all mastication muscle and all muscles which attach to the mandible from lower. Genial hyoid, you can see, myla hyoid and anterior belly of the digastric. Styla hyoid and posterior belly of the digastric, they are placed near stylomastoid opening. By stylomastoid open exists facial nerve, for it is easy to take this muscle. Styla hyoid and the posterior belly of the digastric we gave for the facial nerve. The myla hyoid, genial hyoid and anterior belly of the digastric muscle, and together these groups are called suprahyoid muscles, we gave for the trigeminal nerve. If you remember, the nerve number 11, accessory nerve, we gave for it sternocleidomastoid and trapezium. All another, scalenus anterior, scalenus medial, scalenus posterior, longus coli, longus capitis, sternohyoid, sternocyoid, omohyoid, we give for this nerve. This, do you see, motor portion to which muscle will go, the same name will have. Nervus musculus scalenus anterior, nervus musculus longus coli, nervus musculus sternohyoid. Did you understand? This will be motor function. Did you understand? Okay, look this here, another. From here, and from here, you will collect the sensory fiber. And again, from superior and from inferior root, you will collect sensory fiber. We will produce the sensory fiber. Listen to me. Do you see this mixing? This mixing is called plexus. Where it is placed, this is sternocleidomastoid muscle. Do you see? And this mixing will be behind of it. And sensory fibers, they exist to the skin, where they exist near the lateral margin of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Do you see? Sensory portion. They will go by short distance to optic. Here, do you see sternocleidomastoid muscle? One nerve will exist, do you see, and will locate behind of the ear. And will go up. It is called the auricularis major, auricularis major, this auricularis major. Another will go also, do you see, below, to the occipital region, auricularis minor. Another will go to the skin laterally above the clavicle, it's called supraclavicular, never supraclavicular. Another, look at here, rotates around of the anterior side of the sternocleidomastoid and controls the skin in front. Transverse coli. Transverse coli, supraclavicularis, occipitalis minor, auricularis minor. You see how they exist by short distance around the, do you see, they exist, they control the skin. These are sensory or skin branches of the cervical plexus. Did you understand? Listen to me another. Another note, collect from the superior, from inferior motor function. It collects from the superior, from inferior root sensory function. And it is long. It enters into the thoracic cavity, goes below, near the roots of the lungs, one is in front of another is behind, right is in front of the left is behind, and comes by motor portion to the diaphragm. It's called the nervous phrenicus. Diaphragm is very biggest muscle for the expiration and inspiration. Yes? Motor portion will come to the diaphragm. If will be, do you see, problem with this nerve will be paralysis of the diaphragm. We cannot do accident, inspiration and expiration. We can do only by, do you see, external muscles. Do you see, we don't work by diaphragm. And listen to the motor portion comes to the diaphragm. Sensory portion, what controls? Fluid of the thoracic cavity and the viscera. Pericardium, this is the serous membrane for the heart. If the patient will have pleuritis, he will get the pain into the spinal cord and after that to the brain. And then we can keep it again. If you have pericarditis or pleuritis, we will get the pain to the spinal cord after the photocontagion analysis to the brain. Did I say? But do you remember? Fluid and pericardium is innervated by sensory portion and by motor portion it innervates the diaphragm. But do you remember from diaphragm to the liver comes the coronary ligament? Do you remember? Listen to me. The phrenic nerve continues from diaphragm and innervates this ligament. Look at here. You can see here sternal leg, clavicular leg of the sternal leg and the muscle. Behind of them, by this triangle, into the thoracic cavity, direct phrenic nerve. Listen. Listen to me. If we will do, look at me, if we will do pressing by finger between these two legs, look at my pen. Listen, you can see, here is nose, you see, I do pressing, this is, and it will be extended by my pressing from liver. If the patient has normal liver, no problem. If the patient has the inflammation of the liver, here the pain will increase, well, because I will stretch the nose by pressing. This is called phrenic symptom. Phrenic symptom is especially for the differentiation of the disease of the liver. Therefore, you can see this is phrenic nerve. Nervous phrenicus. Nervous phrenicus by sensory portion innervates the ligaments of the liver. Fluid, pericardium, by motor portion innervates the diaphragmatic muscle. Did you see? My dear, for the more of north and for the more of west, we have constant anatomical order. From the beginning to the opus, the north like arches go by short distance. And here you showed examples. Do you see? Muscular north motor portion exhibits and innervates here the muscle. The sensory portion exhibits and innervates here the skin around the phrenic nerve. You can see the diaphragm. If you remember, diaphragm is developed from cervical myotome. Yes? And through the sphincter, diaphragm, which develops from cervical myotome, is placed very upper. When we get the new burn, we are very aggressive for him. We push him, we cover it, him by cold water. We want to listen to his crying. How he cries, lungs expand by visit of the air and to this to the diaphragm. Diaphragm takes with each phrenic nerve. Because through the fetal life and through the embryonal life, our order about short distance from north to the opposite yolk after fetal life doesn't work. Did you see? You can see this is plexus cervicalis. This is cervical plexus. It includes one mixed nerve, many motor nerves for the muscles of the neck, and four cutaneous or skin branches. auricularis minor, occipitalis minus, supra clavicularis and transversus humerus. Idiot. Supra clavicularis. Lateral side of the neck above the clavicle. Didn't it? And transverse coil in front of the sternocleidomastoid adamastoid muscle as usual. Listen to me. At first, I explained you the spinal nerve. Each spinal nerve includes sensory and motor portion and divides into the posterior and anterior branch. This in the cervical region, anterior branches mix and do less. This posterior branches by segmental according will go to the back. From another segment of C378 again. Posterior branches will go to the back. Do you see? Will go to the back. Cutaneous and motor. Anterior branches will go in front of. Anterior branches will go in front of the sensory and motor portion. And they mix. All these branches, they mix. And they complete a cord into the lateral trunk, which is into the medial trunk, which is in, and into the posterior trunk. This is this. Look here. This we will study later. This is not today's material. I want to finish this lecture. Sure enough, but here we have mixing and separation. And here, at first, this mixing divides into three trunks. This will be in the axillary cavity. This will be lateral, medial, and posterior. And distally, will subdivide into the one mixed node, which will go to the upper limb, into the another mixed node, which will go deeper to the upper limb, and into the another mixed node. We have four mixed nodes, and two on the medial side from medial trunk, and we have only two sensory skin branches. You can see at first divide into three trunks will subdivide into the individual nodes. More of them will collect from any trunk from which it will be used. Sensory motor portion from medial trunk besides either nerve will begin with two skin nerves. This will be brachial cleft. Posterior branches, again will go to the back. This is by straight position by segmental position. In the thoracic region, anterior branches will align into its intercostal space. The motor portion will innervate intercostal muscles, the sensory portion, the skin. This is the skin superficial than this intercostal space. Posterior branches by same direction will go to the back. About what I want to inform you, only in the thoracic region will be situation like on the back. Segmental according. Dorsal branches or posterior branches every time have segmental according. And the anterior branches in the cervical region of flexus. In the another lower cervical region will do brachial flexus. The nerve which will exit from lumbar segmentus at first will mix, after that will subdivide into the branches. The nerve which exits from cervical segment will mix, after that will divide into the individual nerve. This will be reactive. in the thoracic region, anterior branches will go visit by their individual intercostal space. Posterior branches every time will go by segmental space. Do you think? You can see this is information about cervical rectus, and I went so in front for the information about brachial. And I tell you, posterior branches every time from their exit horizontally will direct to the back and will have segmental atrophy. The sensory portion will innervate skin. By this segmental atrophy, the motor portion, the muscles behind of this portion of the skin. Did you say? Who has atlas?
Back on the body. Do you see? You can see posterior branches here, everywhere will exit, and the cutaneous will innervate skin, the motor behind of the skin muscle. Cutaneous will innervate skin, the motor behind of them, this level of the muscle. Do you see? In the thoracic region, anterior branches will have the same. They will not complete into the plexus. They will locate, do you see, like, do you see, straighted condition, do you see, along of the thoracic cavity. Now I will give you questions. You will